Fathers of Reddit, what is the best way you have messed with a daughter's boyfriend when meeting him? The first thing my ex's dad said to me was, "You can sleep in my daughter's bed tonight," and I replied, "Thanks, you too," because I was too nervous. A mate was arrested for drug possession by his girlfriend's police officer father. He was going to be introduced to the family that weekend anyway. Would have loved to be a fly on the wall that evening. Boyfriend: hello, future father-in-law. First of all, I want to apologize for my twin brother. He is the black sheep of the family, and in no way representative of my or my parents' values and culture. The first time I met my girlfriend's father, he picked us both up and was driving us to his house so we could stay the weekend. After a few minutes of driving, he told us he had to make a stop on the way there. He pulled up outside a house that looked like there was some work being done on it, and one of the guys came up to the car and said hello. My girlfriend's dad handed over this fat envelope of cash to the guy, and the guy gave him a clear blue plastic bag full of this white powder, which my girlfriend's dad threw in the back with us. At this point, I'm pretty freaked the frick out because I'm fairly convinced that my girlfriend's dad just paid a load of money for a bag full of coke, but I try to act cool. My girlfriend's dad is like, "I can trust you not to say anything, right?" And I'm like, "Yeah, sure," because I don't wanna get freaking killed or something. So about 15 minutes later into the journey, my girlfriend just bursts out laughing and they tell me it was all just a prank. My girlfriend's dad owned the property being worked on and had to pay the workers for it, and had staged that the worker was gonna give him a big bag of washing powder to freak me out. It was a pretty hilarious and harmless prank and we laugh about it now. He's a cool guy. Plot twist: they were too worried you were going to knock about it, so they lied to you and told you it was a prank while they've been pushing bricks for years now. I asked him for three forms of it. He was 14. Mid-30s and I don't even have three forms of it. Beat him up in Battlefield and a few other video games. I'm almost 50 and have been a gamer since my early teens. I have more experience with games than he has. As a teen, this isn't you fricking with me. This is you bonding with me immediately. I had a boyfriend named Nelson. My dad took great pleasure in doing Nelson's laugh from The Simpsons whenever my boyfriend came over. We didn't last long. I wasn't the father, I was the boyfriend. I wanted to take my girlfriend out to see a movie, but she said that I had to meet her dad first. Her dad runs the local farmer's market, so I had to stop by that morning. Luckily, it was winding down because after an awkward hello, he put his hand on my shoulder and led me around and introduced me to everyone at all the stands. Now, for an introvert as myself, this would have been bad enough. But no, as he was introducing me to everyone, he used random female names for me. "Hi there, so and so. This here's Stephanie and he's taking my daughter on her first date. Hey guys, meet Martha. He's taking my daughter out." It was kind of funny afterwards. Well, my current girlfriend told me about how her dad answered the daughter her junior year homecoming date. Her first boyfriend, with a shotgun on his shoulder. 5 years later, I visited her at her parents' house for the first time. I had met them briefly when they visited us at university, so I knew them a little bit. When I pulled into their driveway, she texted me to come in through the garage door and knock with a smiley face at the end. I figured her dad was going to pull the same thing on me. Turns out it was just so their dogs wouldn't freak out. She answered the door and her dad greeted me shortly after with a warm handshake and a plethora of snacks he had made in preparation for the football games that afternoon. I felt at home pretty quickly. Not the dad but the boyf. He challenged me to a game of Monopoly under the impression that he was an incredible player and kept giving me drinks. Kept acting like I needed to prove my worth through the game. To his credit, he did beat the rest of his family. By the end, I was a drunken owner of hotels on almost every street, all the stations and utilities. He respected my brutal corporate efficiency that day. No matter what the boy's name is, shake his hand politely and say, "It's great to see you again, Jared." Note, this has not been tested with a boy actually named Jared yet. The first time I met my ex's dad, he had just had surgery. I think I was 15 at the time, and while I was waiting for her, he asked me if I would go into the study and put on some music and make him a drink. I got him a single Jameson with one ice cube because that's what my Irish family members drank, and I knew he was a Hibernian, and I put on a Fleetwood Mac record because he had an awesome player set up. That was him testing me apparently. He told me later that I passed because I didn't just plug my phone into their auxiliary cord and grab him a beer. I hung out with him once way later on after his daughter and I had broken up, and he ordered me a Jameson with a single ice cube on his way out of the bar. But look, I don't know what you are into, but, you know, I was the first guy who she ever peed on and I still cherish that memory. This wasn't my dad, but my brother. I brought my BF home for a week over the summer. We are in college and live in separate states when not at school, and I was very excited for him to meet my family. I had already met his and they were pretty cool. My parents were very nice and normal to him, but when we sat down for dinner that night, my brother, who is 2 years younger than me, came downstairs, chatted normally for a bit, then said wait here. He runs up to his room and comes back down about 5 minutes later with a stack of papers and a pen, and sets it down in front of my BF. It's a quiz. It was a quiz. A little quiz that he had typed out. He made him put his name and the date and everything. The questions were divided into three categories: sports, music, and movies. They were all things my brother considered vital for my BF to know if he ever wanted to truly belong to my family. My BF, being the cool guy that he is, took it all in stride, and only got 2 wrong on the whole 30 question quiz, with no preparation or studying at all. My family was suitably impressed, and he's still around a year and a half later. I'm the daughter. Dad and his best friend dressed up in Speedos, mowed the lawn, BBQ'd, held hands, sang horribly off-key together, and nicknamed the poor soul Mick Big Mac. He stopped hanging out with me after that. Dad and his best friend still do weird crap like this together, and they are my favorite people. Right? Dad's best friend was the boyfriend. Walked into the cleaning the guns gag. He asked, "What are your intentions with my daughter?" And without missing a beat, because I sometimes lack a filter, I replied, "Depends. What do you think I can get away with?" Her mother laughed so hard she dropped a glass and broke it. Called him the wrong name the whole time. The same name, on purpose. Boyfriend now husband, came over to meet her extended family for Thanksgiving. Sat down next to her uncle. He looks over at me and says, "I'm gay, you know," and stares at me. I replied back with "me too," and moved closer to him. Practically sat on his lap. "I like this guy, been married to her for 2 years and been together for 8 years now. Her family is hilarious." Daughter here. First time I bring my BF to my hometown, we visit my parents. My mom tries to stuff him with food while my dad excitedly describes the great deal he got on my sister's new car. My boyfriend comes to join me in the middle of this and my dad stops, looks him dead in the eye, and excitedly says, "Wanna see something cool?" He then proceeds to get on the computer and turns the screen to my boyfriend and I. We are greeted with a picture of my dad when he was 21. Buff, shirtless, and flexing. I begin to cover my face in embarrassment as my dad looks excitedly at my boyfriend for a response. My boyfriend simply says, "You look good, man." Pretty sure my dad did this to embarrass me instead of mess with my boyfriend, but did put him in a pickle for a second there. My boyfriend now makes jokes about how hot my dad is just to embarrass me more. I call this the worst first date experience thanks to my dad. I had moved to a new school in the third grade, and fell in elementary love with a boy wearing those pants that unzip to reveal shorter pants, or shorts. It was not until the fifth grade, after endless diary entries and tampered with MASH outcomes, that my crush finally asked me out on a date. My dad immediately said no, and I sobbed. I sobbed and sobbed, until my mother talked my dad into letting me go. The only problem was, he was coming too. I decided not to tell my crush that my father would be attending the date with us, but instead pretended to be just as confused as he was that an older man was sitting directly behind us during the movie. The movie was just Married. My poor crush tried to put his arm around me, and I felt my face flush as a voice from behind us said, "You want to keep that arm?" My father laughs to this day about how far we were leaning away from each other after that, and is very pleased with himself that he ended any affectionate advances. What my dad doesn't know is that we kissed every recess after that date until our terribly dramatic breakup on the soccer field. I will wordlessly toss a freshly killed fish at him. If he catches it, he can stay for a time. And this is why Walmart banned you from the seafood aisle. I went to tell my new father-in-law that I was serious with his daughter and intended to marry her. He interpreted it as me asking for his permission and told me now isn't the right time. Maybe in a few years. That really messed me up. Good guy. Language barrier. It all worked out in the end. We hosted a beautiful teenaged exchange student for a year. When a boy came to take her to a dance, I looked down at him and said, in roughly these words, "I am responsible for her right now, but her real father is even bigger than me, and you don't want to do anything that would pee off both of us." Not a father, but if I have a daughter, I want to dress like a clown and say I'm off to work. Brother to the sister that brought him home. My old man wrote his name on a 12-gauge shell and set it on the mantel above the fireplace and said nothing. It was about halfway through dinner before he noticed it. I've never seen a face get so white so quick in all my life. They're married now. Shell is still sitting there. I was the boyfriend in this case, but this one has always stuck with me. Everyone knows the old dad is cleaning his gun cliche. Well, this is a slightly different variation of that. He was polishing a sledgehammer. It turned out he was actively just screwing with me and didn't care. But I had to give him credit for creativity and for leaving me at an absolute loss when I walked into their living room and saw the gleam from the shiny hammer. I was the boyfriend. My girlfriend warned me that her dad liked to be sitting in his chair cleaning his shotgun whenever one of the girls brought a boy over to meet the parents. She told me that the gun was a relic and had been disabled or deactivated or some dang thing. Don't remember the exact term. She said he was real proud of it, and said it was a Springfield something or other. So I walked in, and there he was. I said, "Hey, nice Springfield something or other," and asked if I could hold it. He handed it to me, and I looked at it and said, "When did you have it deactivated?" The girls, who were all watching, smiled. He wasn't amused, especially after he started a discussion about guns and it was clear I didn't know anything about them. He eventually figured out that she warned me, and he was none too pleased at how bold I was. I just thought it was funny. That was the start of a long and rocky relationship with that man. Much to his dismay, I married his daughter. Now that I am the dad, I grill the boyfriends about what my daughter has told them about me and her mother. My being a forensic investigator is not something my daughter's usually led with, I have found. And my comments about knowing how to make it look accidental are usually met with some level of clenching. My dad is very good at deadpanning. Upon meeting my boyfriend, dad told him that he was too tall. He is almost 7 feet. He wasn't sure if my dad was messing with him or was actually serious. I had to explain later that a good portion of what dad says should be taken with a grain of salt. My dad has told every single one of the guys I've brought home, even if they were just friends, that he's not afraid to go back to jail. My dad has never been to jail. My daughters are 2 and 4. When my oldest was born, I started working out again. I've found the best inspiration on days when I'm feeling lazy is to imagine myself as some nearly mythical titan ripping the door off its hinges to greet some poor kid intent on taking my daughter on a date. So my plan is long term and I'll check back and let you all know how it goes. My pawpaw greeted my aunt's boyfriend with a single gunshot out the front door, into the old gutted truck about 20 yards from the main driveway. He still fires off a greeting shot when they come in from out of town. 17 years later. I'm trying to decide if that sounds more West Virginia or Alabama. My father used to make sure he was working his heavy bag when anyone came over to pick up my sisters. He'd shake the whole dang house. Obligatory not a father, but my co-worker just walked up to his daughter's new boyfriend, took a picture of his face with his phone and said maybe good to have and walked away. I made up a game. I call them by a different name every time I address them. Goal is to see how many names I can call them before they correct me. Record is 27 in one visit. My dad always calls my boyfriend's watch his face until he gains respect for the guy. My current boyfriend just recently got his name privilege, which has happened I think twice. When I brought my first real boyfriend home for dinner for the first time, I forgot to mention that my dad was also home for dinner. He's a policeman and comes home for meals, so we rock up and there's a police car in the driveway. It's normal for me, but my boyfriend's face was literally